It's about that time.
Re-record on my count. 7, 6, 5.
Then with the coach, Mickey Clayton, on Insights. Two eyes in the middle. INSIIGHTS, where we always talk the
testing,
talk.
Testing.
Got you.
You got me?
I do.
We here with Corey Fuller. Corey, congratulations. You're doing one heck of a job, big guy.
Thank you.
You know, it seems like good teams follow you around.
No, I don't know if it's good teams. I don't want to inherit good teams. I try to make them good teams, but what I have here is a soul of rich talent. So it wasn't very hard, as hard as it's been at the other places I've made stops at.
Coach, inherit good talent. Coach, you won more games this year than they've won the last 2 years put together.
Yeah, but I have a great group of kids.
Coach, traditionally this has been an excellent program over the years.
Yeah, they've had their down years, but they've had a lot of up years. The history says that they've played for 6 state titles. They've won 4 of them, starting all the way back from 76 to 2012. The last time they played them was 2014. But they've played for 6 of them in school history. Nobody in Leon County has, in public schools, have more state titles than Godby. So a lot of times, a lot of people like to talk about what they're doing and this and that. My whole attitude and motto when I got back here is get the wheel back on the right track. Because history said we'll get to Orlando.
What's it like on campus?
You know, we're not even having a pep rally this week. We're not having a pep rally. I think the mindset is it's always big around here. And I played football so long, coach, that every game is big. This is just significantly different because it's in our district, but you can't make it no bigger than the one that was the week before. And if I do, now I'm putting pressure on the kids, I'm putting pressure on myself. And at the end of the day, it's just a football game and I'm dealing with kids.
Well, you had one hurdle. Tell you what color early.
Yes.
That 21-6 or something like that.
Right.
Okay, what did it tell you in terms of getting ready for what you have to do?
But it didn't really tell us nothing. Walcullers a different style than Rickards. Rickards want to high fly and make big plays. Walcullers want to grind you out. Either way, either style we play, we're going to adapt to. So if they want to high fly, we'll high fly at the quarterback. If they want to sit there trying to go power for power with us, we'll go power for power. We're sort of like an Alabama. It ain't always going to look pretty. We're going to get the job done on all 3 phases. I think that people are caught up today in points, but honestly, we average 33-some points a game. I'm just so pleased with the way the team has committed. See, when I don't use that word buy-in. I told you that before. Because when you buy in, you can take it back. They committed to a style of old school football here with the athletes, with the physicality, with the big linemen and skilled kids. They committed to a style of physical football.
What was the biggest thing you had to overcome coming in? I mean, a lot of times people say when teams haven't had success, they don't believe in themselves.
I haven't seen players that won more games now than won 2 or 3 years they've been on the team. So what we had to overcome was getting kids to really believe that you're supposed to win. Nobody saw this coming but God, me, and the kids and the system coaches. So we're not surprised where we're at. We said from day one that we want to come back and take the district title. We're not worried about state titles. We're not worried about Big Ben champ. We worried about state titles here, guy.
Well, you always felt that you were a motivated man.
Right.
And I'm sure that you feeling like you were going to change their mindset wasn't going to be that hard for you.
No, you changed mindset to discipline, but most of all through love. And I just have a unique gift right now to assemble men and then young boys and get them to believe in one cause. The one cause that we first start off with is changing lives. Because we invest in our kids. If you invest in the kids, you're going to win. I don't have to worry about X and O's then. You don't see no stuff drawn up in our own football plays on it. But what you will find is me dissecting, looking at other people and what they do with young people and men as leaders. And that's what I surround myself with in my mind with and my heart with, is trying to change people. And kids, not football players. They're gonna be the same. Been the same for 100 years. Power style, sweep is sweep. Flea flicker, option is option. But every day, every week, every month, I have to come up with some type of new tool to energize these kids and these coaches.
How many coaches did you bring with you?
From these guys, I probably brought three, and then I hired about eight more.
So you turned the staff all the way around?
Pretty much.
Okay. Yeah. How's the administration been? They've been supportive?
Yeah, Ms. Bell hired me. She left and she took a new job at the county office. And then Mr. Cole is a football guy. He's not a Rickards alum. He's from Miami, graduated from Florida A&M though. But he loves Godby. He loves sports, and that's a great plus to have as a principal, someone that loves sports.
He loves kids.
He loves kids and he loves discipline. So me and him on the same page with what we try to do at Godby. I think that we did need a new hall for the discipline at the school. And it's just paid off.
Well, I met him when he came over to New Mount Zion for Vacation Bible School.
Right.
And spoke to one of the classes that I was teaching. And spoke well. You could feel his commitment in his words. So I thought he might be a good fit.
He's a great fit for our kids in our school and the atmosphere of time of dealing with young people. Because the experiment he's had from elementary to middle school and now to high school is translating over. A lot of these kids he's already taught before at the school. So that makes it a plus. He's getting the staff, all of us on the same page. We're all working together to save kids. My attitude on that is that they weren't ready, but God made it a perfect time now. And with that timing that I do a great job for someone else that's looking for an opportunity to be a coach one day. In some other county, some other superintendent, some other principal can see a fit to give an Afro-American a chance at a place they never had a chance at. Because we can do a good job, in spite of what you may think or may feel. I know my hire probably was surprising, but not so far out of the way. If you look at what I've done in the game of football and what I do with young people. So I'm grateful for it. I'm thankful that God put me in this situation. That's why it was hard to turn down this job, because of the opportunity to really get to Orlando. It's hard to win a championship at any level. You know that as a former coach. But it's been proven and tested and done at Godby. So I had to dive in and try it.
What high school you originally went to?
Rickards. Class of 1990.
How's it feel playing against them?
Well, I played against Rickards for being at East Gaston and not Gaston County High. So it's a little different now because I'm actually in the city and I'm in the same district. So the one of this seat actually takes, when we win the district. The people that was at Rickards when I was there is gone. It's like at Florida State, the people that was there when I was there, they're gone. It's always gonna be a part of me. It helped shape me, it helped mold me. I can't never forget, I'm a blue and gold guy, I'm a Redskin. I can't forget I'm a Garden and Gold guy, I'm a Sun and Gold. When they lose, I hurt. When they win, I feel good. It's up 1 week of the year. When they facing me, it has to be 1 week in my mind, and it's all business. I can't save my kid by losing to my alma mater. I try to get my kids to understand, the one thing about God and Rickards kids, we all come from the same type of communities. I think sometimes off the field, we take our community too far for our toughness. And I want our kids to understand, you can be tough. Be tough in the right way. Be tough in the classroom. Be tough in being respectful to your mother, if your father's there. Be tough in trying to have ambition and dream and goals for your life. Don't be tough with a gun. Don't be tough with cuss words. Don't be tough with trying to be grown too early. I think a lot of times we don't have a vision for our life and we think because we come from where we come from, there's no better. That's not true. I am one of y'all. I understand your pain. I understand going to bed hungry. I understand not having all the clothes and the final things. But today, you kids went to Michael Jordan. I wouldn't have dared ask my mom for nothing like that when I was growing up. But so I don't really understand, but I do know this right here. We have too many of our young people going broke to play like and to look like they're rich instead of looking like you broke and one day be rich. So this rivalry is deep. I never beat God when I was a rookie. This is the one high school I didn't beat. And when I told him I got hired, I said, since I couldn't beat you, I joined him. And I'm grateful for the opportunity. I'm grateful to try to keep putting me young people alive every day and trying to make a difference.
Well, Coach Fuller, those are some profound words, which we will repeat again.
Right.
I think some more people need to hear that. And I, Mickey Clayton, want to thank you, Corey Fuller, for all that you've done for Insights at your previous stop. And here at Godby, you know, Godby wasn't one of our schools, and it is not. And thank you for your contribution to that, for pushing Insights High School Game of the Week, because the first game we did was you and Childs.
Right, yeah, it was a great game, and it was a great coverage and great atmosphere. And I want to thank Insight for always trying to cover me and sticking by the mission that I have, because the more coverage I get, the more our kids get seen, the more they get talked about, the more they get heard about, and the more you can see the work that we're really doing. A lot of times, it goes under the bar and the radar, the real effect of a high school coach and the effect of a teacher and a principal. And what y'all are doing is putting out a brand that helps us display the work that we're putting in. The Bible spoke to me, it speaks about don't despise small beginnings. Everybody has to start from somewhere. There are very few people that are born with a silver spoon and gold spoon in their mouth. So we have to understand that don't despise your small beginnings, man. Insight, next thing you know, somebody want to buy you and turn Insight into a big Insight. So I do believe that where there's vision, there's hope. Because where there's no vision, there definitely is no hope. So I thank y'all for always covering us and making it right for me and the kids.
Well, thank you. That was our vision. And Coach Fuller, we wish you a lot of luck. Win, lose, or draw, you still get in the district, correct?
I'm not tied to make the playoff because I schedule. But I don't like to talk about yumps. I don't like to talk about luck. You create the fortune you want in life as people. And luck is in lottery tickets. Luck is in horseshoe. In football, you create your breaks. And in life, you create the breaks the way you want your life to be, by hard work, and discipline, structure, love, and respect.
We appreciate you, Coach.
Thank you.
See you, because I know you're a supporter of every school you go. You're there supporting the team. We'll see you during basketball season.
Yes.
Supporting the rest of the teams here in Godby.
Yes,
that I know for a fact.
Definitely, for sure. And maybe I'll visit Rickards.
Okay. And this we have, we're going to sign off. But as always, it's always enlightening to have an opportunity to talk to Coach Fuller, a homeboy that's home.
From Insights, visit our website at insights.com. Two eyes in the middle, INSIIGHTS.
Insights is a copyright of MacFor Enterprises, a Florida corporation. This broadcast is produced under the exclusive ownership of MacFor Enterprises and is the intellectual property and trademark of MacFor Enterprises. Comments of the host and other individual speakers on Insights represent the independent thoughts and representation. One, two, three.